Sabi Dias. I'm from Goa. I'm a seafarer by the profession. I'm staying with my parents and my three brothers. As a young and ambitious seafarer, I was working in the sea for 3 years. I joined a seafarer at a very young age, and I had very good contracts with my company, and I was growing very fast, and I've been promoted very quickly in all my contracts. And as a time came when I was almost at the position which I was expecting, and I had a position, I fell sick. I had friends, it's like a family member on high seas, but they all left me as I was in a higher position than them. In that all things, like, they put me away, and I was not feeling well, I was sick, and I had to leave the job. And I left the job in 2014, and I came down home, and I was just at home for 6 months. I went to the big deep depression. I was not doing anything. I was just staying in my room. I was not going out. I remember my mom was to call my friend to take me out, but I never used to leave my room. After 6 months, my neighbor, she decided to take me to the Divine. And the first time I came in Divine was in 2016. I did my first retreat as a normal retreat, because I used to attend a retreats back home. I just did a normal retreat, and I went home, and I felt like there was nothing changed. I just went home. I was still looking for a job, going through all the offices, the agencies, everywhere. Nothing was happening. Then she said again to me next year, when the summer holiday, she said, okay, let's go again for another retreat. So I came again for another retreat, and we had another group of family with us in the retreat, which just joined us on the station. And the retreat was started like 1 day, 2 days. And the third day, the family member got sick. He was a drug addict, and he was sick, and he could not control himself. So we had to move him to the one of Divine's rehabilitation center. And the people over there, they said, like, there need to be someone with him who has to be there. And me and my another family member, we stayed with him in the Divine for 2 days to 2.5 days. And I thought, like, again, this was my retreat, which wasn't fruitful again. Nothing will work. But we were praying there, and they were calling us from here that we are praying for you. Everything gonna work out. And on a Friday afternoon, in the morning, we came here. They said, okay, he's fine now, you have to go home. So we came back here in the retreat, and I was sitting in the last seats of the retreat. And I was like, I didn't do the proper retreat. There was no confession, no counseling, nothing, no sessions, nothing. And I wasn't happy that the second time I came, and nothing will gonna work out again. I'm not gonna listen to God as well. I was just sitting. And the last prayers were going on when the father was giving the last prayer. And the father said, there is someone who's going to heal now. He was here for the retreat for 2 times. I know that nothing had worked out for you. He was here, and you didn't attend the retreat, but there is something going to happen in your life. Whatever you are praying for, you're gonna get it. And I felt like I am the one. I was so confident that I am the one. Father is talking to me. Jesus is talking to me, to the Father. I am the one who's going to get everything what I have been praying for. And we went home, and just the next week, I got the mail from my office that you have to join immediately. I got a job in 2017, and I came back again in 18 for a Thanksgiving retreat. And I went again to my company for the third contract, and things worked out so well. Everything was going so good. All my plans, everything what I was planning, everything what I've been doing is going so well. I'm so happy that I'm doing this retreat again. This time it's just a Thanksgiving, because I promised myself, whenever it's possible for me, I will do the retreat.
My name is Raymond, and I am from Mangalore. It started with the scripture, do not fear, for I am with you. I am your God. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will uphold you and strengthen you with my righteous right hand. Isaiah 41:10. It was back in 2005 that I had gone to Bombay and started with my work. And I was literally struggling to find a job then. Back then, since I got into BPO industry, and I started with taking up alcohol, which I literally virtually or hating to drink alcohol before. It started with small drinks that it ended up to be a heavy drinker in my stage until 2012. From 2005 to 2012, I was in alcohol, smoking, and may not be the worst of sins that I might have committed when I was in this bondage. And there came a time in 2012 when my parents were looking out for a proposal for me, and I said, okay, this is a time when I have to settle in my life. And I got married in the year 2012, May. I was still in the trading gamble thing, the addiction of investments. But then that is a time when I happened to lose more money, and it all went off from my hand, slipped off. And I got a pressure from the family stating that I need to support financially. When I was totally broke, I had some loans to be paid off, some credit cards to be paid off, and I could not do anything on my own. There was totally no hope in my life whatsoever. And during this phase of time, I realized from even past days, I was feeling that I have to come to retreat, Divine Retreat Center. I met one of my friend who had been to this retreat center, and he told me, Raimundo, you go there, your problems will be resolved. I said, now there is no hope for me in life, whatever. God is the only hope wherein I can, if he cannot control, then if cannot take the charge of resolving my issues, then I may not be able to do anything on my own. And that's when I came down. I ended up coming to Divine. In fact, I did not have money. I borrowed from one of my friends there, and I came down to Divine Retreat Center from Mangalore. The second day of the retreat, as and when the Inner Wound session was going on by Father Joseph Iratu, he explained his inner wounds in such a manner, and I tried realizing from where I am actually, what has happened in my life, in the past, and how much God had in fact loved me in all these years. Even in my failures, he was there with me, and he was still loving me, even though I was in the sin. I cried in front of the Blessed Sacrament and saying, Lord, please forgive me for all my past. And I repented to my heart and I said, Lord, please forgive me. Give me another chance to be faithful to you in all my ways. And as I was crying, there was some electrifying shivering. The body was totally trembling, and I was in tears. And as this was happening to me, Father Joseph Iratu called out my name on the stage and said, Raimundo, this is what the Lord says. Do not fear. I am with you always. And that's when I realized I had a joy of experience of the joy, and the tears of joy was just rolling. And I, 15 minutes, I could not even stand up on my feet. I was just crying and crying like a small baby. I could feel the lightness in me, and I was just feeling. I went home, spoke to my parents after a long time. I was sorry for whatever was done, and slowly, gradually, the things started moving in my life. The first job assignment was in Dubai. I went abroad. I saw how the Lord worked throughout this phase. Like, I had no finances, but the arrangement was done, and the job, that was a miracle again. All the miracles were just working in my life year after year, and things were just moving in. And to give you a small instance, the Lord was so faithful in every way. Even my dad, who was 45 years alcoholic, he has given up his alcohol 2 years back. It's all the prayers and the grace of the Lord that just flows in. He restored my marital status, and he gave me a very good wife. I glorify and thank the Lord in every circumstances, whatever he has done in my life. I'm again come here to witness to the Lord, the word of God that has strengthened me is the Bible verse Isaiah 41:10, which says, do not fear, do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I'll uphold and strengthen you with my righteous right hand.
My name is Shobana. I come from Coimbatore. I'm a homemaker. I have two children, a daughter and a son. We have been coming to Divine for many years. We come with our family. We receive so many blessings from the retreat. Actually, my daughter, she completed her engineering here in Coimbatore. After completing her MS, due to the governmental policies, she was not able to get any job. She couldn't even get an interview. She'll call up and say, "Mom, I'm not even getting an interview. How will I get a job?" She was very much stressed and worried about it. And I said, "The Lord will take care of it." So I decided to make a retreat here in Divine. I came in July 2018, and I prayed to the Lord that He should give my daughter a good job in America. And while Father Augustine Valoran was conducting the benediction, he was saying that one person here is asking the Lord for a job in America, and he is assuring that person that he is giving that job now. You start thanking the Lord, he said. And he gave me a word from Jeremiah 29:11, "The plans I have for you is plans for prosperity." So I took it into me, and then I started praying and thanking and praising the Lord. After finishing the retreat, I went home. As soon as I got home, I got a call from my daughter. She told me, "Amma, I got a call from a company, from a, that to a very good chain of companies, a very famous company, Berkshire Hathaway." She said they asked me for my interview. They gave me a telephonic interview and didn't even ask me to come in person, asked me to come and join the next Monday itself for the job. We were all very, very pleased and very happy. She was very happy. I praise the Lord for the wonderful thing that He has done for me and my family. All glory to God. I have come again this year to the Divine Retreat Center to offer a Thanksgiving retreat to the Lord. I thank God and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. My name is John Savio Fernandez. I am from Kota, Rajasthan. By profession, I am a web developer. I was suffering from urinary tract infection from last year. Again and again, this urine infection was taking place. I was fed up. Like second time when I went, I did my urinary test over there. Doctor told me that he will do some test, like kidney test. I used to have again and again reoccurring urine infection. So I was so much fed up and I was so much depressed that why this is happening with me only. The second time when it happened, I went to the doctor, and doctor suggested me a urine test, and also he suggested me X-ray of kidney, because he does not wanted me to spend a lot of money in sonography and all expensive reports. So he just suggested me X-ray just to find out if any stone is there in my kidney or what. So the report came normal. There was no stone in my kidney, but there was some infection in my urine and some traces of albumin was also present in my urine. Basically, albumin is not natural or not normal in urine, because the presence of albumin means that kidney is not functioning properly. So doctor gave me medicines for that infection, and I took those medicines and I was okay. I was fine after 7 to 8 days. I was back to normal life, but again it happened with me. Same thing happened in month of Jan. I was again depressed that recently only I took this treatment and again this same thing is happening. What is the cause reason of this suffering? I went to doctor. Doctor suggested me that it must be something related to my kidney, that it is happening again and again. And even I complained to doctor that I am having a high blood pressure. So doctor suggested me that I should go with some test just to check out the functioning of my kidney, because there was also presence of albumin in my old test reports. So doctor told me that at my age, it is not normal to have a high blood pressure because of heart disease, because as I am a fit person. So he suggested me to go for second cause, that may be a kidney. So he suggested me test of urea, creatinine level, and urine analysis again. So I was totally shocked when I saw the face of doctor, that why he is prescribing me the test related to kidneys. So I asked doctor, is it something wrong with my kidney? Doctor told me there was presence of albumin in your kidney before. I told, yes doctor. So there are chances that your kidney is damaged. And I didn't knew what to do. I went outside, doctor told me go to the lab and submit the samples. I went to the lab, I submitted my urine sample, and those lab technicians took the blood sample, and they told me that you wait outside for some time till the time the reports come. I was totally shocked, but one thing that came into my mind was that I should thank God for this suffering that I am going through, that this depression that I am going through. So I was just thanking, I was sitting outside on the bench. So when I opened my mobile, I opened YouTube, and on YouTube I opened Goodness TV's channel, and the very first video was of Father Augustine. He was preaching over there. I started that video and I started listening to the preaching, what Father Augustine was saying. And as that video was progressing, Father gave a testimony of a lady who was suffering from burden and who was so much distressed, and Father Augustine gave her some message, and that message was Matthew chapter 11 verses 28, come to me all those who are burdened, I will give you rest. And I was just repeating that same word again and again till the video got over. And when the reports came, doctor called me into the cabin and he told me that there is no trace of any infection in my urine. There is no trace of any albumin in my urine. My creatinine level was normal and my urea level was also normal. That means there is no sign of any kidney damage. He prescribed me normal medications for high blood pressure. At that moment, I knew that Jesus has healed me. He has done miracle in my life. He has given me a second chance, because I was in so much pain and I was in so much distress. Again and again, I have done things that made God away from me. After that, I never had any urine infection, and I promise that I will testify this. That is the reason I came to Divine here, to testify, and I know I will never have this urine infection in my life again. I thank and praise God for this healing in my life.
Hello, my name is Marit Rosario. I am from Mangalore. I am 58 years old. I am married and I am having 3 daughters. I had pain in my right knee joint for the last 20 years. And that time I was working in Abu Dhabi, and I had to stand for a long time. And after that, the pain started increasing. And so because of that, I was not able to stand and work for a long time. I was not able to climb the stairs, or I was not able to kneel down when I was going for mass. So the pain was severe. So after that, I consulted orthopedic. Then the orthopedic told me to do an x-ray, and they said the joint has been worn out on the left side of the kneecap, and he advised me that you have to do a kneecap surgery. So I actually didn't want to go for that since I was young, So then doctor said, okay, then I will give you some medication. So he had given me some tablets and he told me to do physiotherapy. So I used to go for physiotherapy and I used to take medications. And especially when I used to had to go for walks or anything, I used to take painkillers because the pain was very severe. So whenever I used to go for any functions or anything, I used to take a painkiller and go, and that used to give me relief. And after that, one day it used to give relief, and the second day again, I used to get back that pain. So then again, the pain became less when I used to take painkillers. But taking painkillers also is not good for a long period. So then doctor again said, you have pain, so there is no other alternative. You have to again, I suggest now, recently, now I'm 58, at about 3 years back when I went to him, he suggested it's better you do replace your kneecap. So again, I was reluctant. I said, don't want, I will stop it. Then after that, I started going for adorations. Then I started attending prayer meetings. I started reading the word of God. Then I came to know if we pray with full faith with God, he will heal me. And after this, one of my relatives said, why not you go to Divine Retreat Center? A lot of, if you go there in faith, definitely he will answer to your prayers. So already I was prepared because I used to sit in front of Blessed Sacrament, I used to read the Bible, and I had hope that ask and you will definitely get. So if I pray in faith, definitely I'll receive. With that hope, I and my husband came to Divine Retreat Center, and I thought I was not kneeling down because doctor had told me not to kneel down. So I thought whether I should kneel or not. But I don't know, automatically once I reached here, the first day only, I knelt down. And after kneeling for so long, I was not getting any pain. I didn't feel any pain. Then I used to stand for hours from morning till evening also. I used to stand, listen to the preachings, and I was to just pray in faith. Ask and you will receive. That was in my mind. I knew definitely he will do something for me. With that hope, every day I used to sit and I used to kneel down, I used to stand, but without any pain. I used to move my legs this side and that side, but I didn't get any pain. So for more than 20 years, I had not gone for confession. So every time I was to go for Mass and receive the Holy Communion, I used to get that feeling, I'm with my sins, I'm receiving Jesus. And I think because of that, God is not answering my prayers. So after that, I went for confession. I confessed all the sins which I had not confessed for the last 20 years. After doing a thorough confession, I was very relieved. After that confession, the very next day, Father announced during the healing session that one person who had pain in the right knee joint is healed. And he told to move my legs. And when I was able to stretch my legs and to bend it or do anything, I didn't get anything. No pain was there. Praise the Lord for that. I was so happy that there is no need for me to go for a surgery, and God has healed. Yes, now after the father priest announced that my knee joint has been healed, even after that 4-5 days, I'm still kneeling down, I'm standing up, I'm walking straight, but there's no pain in my life. I have not even taken a single painkiller after coming here. Well, not even one medication I've taken. Without medication, and I'm able to walk properly, kneel down properly. So I thank and praise God for the message. He said, ask and you will definitely receive. I believed in that with full faith, and I prayed, and my prayers were answered. Jesus has healed me from my knee joint pain.